Hello students, welcome to the class. Today we are going to learn about some animals. In our previous lecture we have learned about the wild animals. So wild animals are the animals those who live in the forest. Today we are going to learn about some domestic animals and we are going to see how these domestic animals are useful to us. We know that the domestic animals are those animals which are kept at our homes or our farms. So, what do you feel? Why do we keep these animals at our houses or our farms? These animals like cows, buffaloes, hens, ducks, they are useful to human beings. They give some products which are very useful to us, and that is why we keep these animals at our houses and farms. So the topic that we are going to learn today or discuss today is the fifth lesson of EVS, that is useful animals. So the animals which are domesticated by human beings, they are useful to him. They are useful in many ways. We get various products from these animals, and that is why we take care of these animals. We keep these animals at our houses or farms. Okay, so let's begin now. The first point that we are going to discuss is about the farm animals. Now, what are farm animals? So, the animals which are reared or which are looked after by the human beings, they are kept at the farms, are called as farm animals. So the animals like cows, buffaloes, hens, ducks and sheep, these are called as the farm animals. Okay, so can you tell me why are they called farm animals? The ox and buffaloes, they can be used for various works in the farms, for various works in the fields. So, they are called as farm animals. Also, the hens, the ducks, the sheep, they give us some products with the help of which we can live our lives easily. So, these animals are useful to human beings. So, the next is milk animals. What are these milk animals? The animals like cows, goats, buffaloes, they give us milk. And milk is a very essential part of human food. So, these animals are called as milk animals. We all know that milk is a complete food. We get various nutrients from the milk. So, these animals like cows, goats and buffaloes, they provide us milk and they are called as milk animals. Also, milk is a very essential product. So also various other products are prepared from the milk. Like we can make curd from the milk. Then we can make buttermilk. Ghee is prepared from the milk. Isn't it? So also paneer is made from milk. Also cheese is prepared from the milk. So there are various milk and milk products that can be prepared from the milk that we obtained from these cows, goats and buffaloes. So these animals are very very helpful and useful for human beings. Okay, so also the egg giving animals. So the animals like hens and ducks, they give us eggs. And egg, as we know, it is also a food product. Some people like to eat eggs. Not all the people. Some people are vegetarian people. They like to eat the food that is obtained from the plants itself. But few people like to eat the non-vegetarian food. That is the food that is obtained from the animals. So the hens and the ducks, they give us eggs and various products are prepared. Or we can say various dishes are prepared from the eggs that we obtain from the hens and ducks. So, the hens and ducks are also domesticated animals and they are kept at the houses or the farms. So, also the next point is flesh and meat. So the animals like hens, goats, crabs, prawns and fish, they give us flesh. So hens they give us eggs, as well as the flesh of the hens is consumed, is eaten by human beings. So also the goats, the flesh of goats is also eaten by human beings. Crabs, what is crabs? Crabs in Marathi we call it khekda. So also prawns, prawns means jhinga. Okay, also various types of fish are consumed by the people. So hens, goats, crabs, prawns, fish, all these animals are used for flesh and meat. We obtain flesh and meat from these animals, and they are useful to human beings in the form of flesh and meat. So also the sheep. The sheep, they give us wool, isn't it? The hairs of the sheep, they are cut, and then the wool is used in making of yarn. And this yarn is used in knitting of sweaters, socks, caps and various other things. So in winter the atmosphere is very very cold, and in such cold season what do? We human beings like to wear some warm clothes, and the wool, the clothes that are made from the woolen yarn are having very very good capacity to control the temperature. So in winter season we use the woolen clothes like jackets, sweaters, socks, then mufflers, caps and various other things. So the sheep is very useful to human beings because we get wool from it. So also the leather, the leather that is obtained, from where do we get this? The leather is manufactured from the skin of some specific dead animal. So the skin of dead animals like camels, cows, buffaloes and snakes is used to form the leather. It is used, the skin of these dead animals is utilized in manufacturing leather, and this leather is utilized in manufacturing of various products like belts, bags, then small purses. Yes, belts are made from it. Jackets are also made from leather. So also wallets are prepared. So various products are manufactured from the leather, which is produced or obtained from the skin of the dead animals. But sometimes what is done? The animals are killed to obtain this skin, which is very very bad. It is true that the leather is required for human beings for preparing of various products, but we should not kill the animals to obtain their skin. When the animal dies, we can get the skin from that animal, but in order to get the skin, we should never kill the animals. So these were some of the useful animals, and we saw some products that we get from these animals.
These are some milking animals, that is the animals like cow, goat, buffalo, they give us milk, and milk is a complete food. It gives us various nutrients. Also milk is used in making various other products like butter, ghee, curd, buttermilk, cheese, paneer, khoya, etc. The hens and ducks give us eggs. Eggs are a good source of protein. Various dishes are produced with the help of eggs. Some animals also give us flesh. The animals like hens, goats, fish, prawn, crab, they give us flesh. The flesh or meat of these animals is eaten by human beings. The flesh is cooked and then consumed by human beings.